Good afternoon to all of you, and welcome back to this post-lunch session. As we had mentioned earlier, we'll spend about 1 hour, maybe a little more, 1 hour, 15 minutes or so in the classroom. We'll do a walkthrough of how you can upload your resource creation assignments to make your own portfolio that you and your colleagues can use when you're teaching. And then we'll do some amount of interaction, Q&A interaction. We'll do a flow transfer, as well as look at questions that appeared in the chat and the questions window throughout the morning. So right now, Jayakrishnan will take over for the next few minutes, and we will look at how to use the course portfolio and test wiki in Moodle.
So before I start off with the session, I'll first have a AVIEW poll set up for you. It is all about how many of you have actually accessed the wikis that have been set up in the Moodle. So remote center coordinators, make sure that you just ask the question, how many of the participants from the remote center have accessed the wiki, both the test wiki and course portfolio. And I have just released this question for AVIEW poll. We just need to know how many participants across centers have used it. The typical answers are all of the participants, maybe around more than 75% of the participants, around 50 to 75% of the participants, or 25 to 50% of the participants, or less than 25% of the participants. So we just need to see how many are familiar with this particular wikis that are there in Moodle. Okay, so I see that around 30 centers have responded, and out of that, 12 of them are saying that all of the participants in the RC have accessed the Moodle wiki. With almost 90 centers responding, we have more than 50% of the people saying that around 50 to 75% of the participants in that remote centers have accessed wiki. So for all the people who are saying that less than 50% people have accessed, so for all these people, this session is a walkthrough of what is expected of them. And for all those people who have accessed the wiki, this is just a refresher as to what you are expected to do in this wiki activity. So you would be familiar with this document, with this companion resource that we have already shared. I've just made some modifications. First of all, let me highlight that this is again under Creative Commons license. So you are free to use, distribute, and modify it, including for commercial purpose, provided you acknowledge the source. So this is the Creative Commons license that we are giving you. So the wikis that we have used, so we have given the name course portfolio. So what is a course portfolio? A course portfolio is, from a learner's perspective, it has an organized presentation of a student's education throughout the course. It displays coursework samples, for example, assignments, mini projects, reflections, etc. And it is a synthesis of what they learned from the course. So this is from a learner's perspective. From a teacher's perspective, again, it is an organized collection of what happened in the course. So you have a course portfolio where all students contribute what they did. So the teacher has an understanding as to how active the course participants were, how engaging the assignments are. It also displays coursework artifacts, those assignments and mini projects. It also provides a summative assessment at the end of the course about students' understanding and knowledge. And why we have used Wiki inside Moodle for this course portfolio? Wikis bring an effective way of collaboration within online learning settings. There is a direct transfer of ownership to the participant. So we have put up a community wiki. Since the purpose of this workshop is to create community resources, we have purposefully given a community wiki so that people can falter and the community will be able to correct provide constructive feedback and correct all those mistakes. There is ability to revise and edit, and it is available within your learning management system, that is Moodle. There are two wikis in this FDP. One is a test wiki, the other one is a course portfolio wiki. The test wiki is a sample wiki which participants are instructed to use for practice. Suppose they want to try out some new functionality they think they have discovered. You can directly first do that in the test wiki, and later you can go on and do it in the main course portfolio wiki. The wiki's test wiki is ungraded, but your participation in the course portfolio wiki will be considered for certification. So the course portfolio wiki requires participants to contribute meaningfully, and everyone, each and every participant is a direct owner of the entire wiki. So it is a public wiki where just like how Wikipedia or the other open resources work. This wiki is completely open, so anybody who has access can go and edit any page. So you have to be careful. So as a community, you have to keep watch of what is happening and ensure that proper proper monitoring mechanisms are kept in your page. So a little about basic wiki operations. First, for accessing the wiki, you have to log into Moodle. So give your username that has come to you and then your password. Then you log into it. So then you have to locate the wiki. The test wiki is on top and the course portfolio wiki is in the under the week 2 May to 8 May. So that is the first activity in that particular week. The description of these wikis are also given along with it. So working with test wiki, as I already told you, it is used for practice. Do not worry even if you make any mistakes. It is recommended that you work with the test wiki first, because this is the sandbox that we are giving you to experiment. Now about course portfolio wiki. The course portfolio wiki has a three-level hierarchy. Okay, level one pages, that is the top set of pages, which are created by the course team at IIT Bombay. You will not be typically given edit permissions for this page. So we have enabled that feature. We have locked the main page, and we will ensure that nobody else gets permission to edit this wiki. Level 2 pages are the RC pages. They will be created by the IIT Bombay hub, but it has to be monitored by the remote center coordinators, remote center or the workshop coordinators, whoever is handling it. You will have to ensure that your remote center page does not get affected by any participant action. And level 3 are the participant pages, the pages that you create. This is your own portfolio that we are looking at. So this portfolio page, it is completely under your ownership, and we will not be doing any changes from our side. So you are responsible for your own page. You should continuously monitor this page so as to see that nobody else has made any changes in your page. And people who have already done it, we request the participants to help the others who are not yet familiar with this wiki interface. We want a lot of community handholding. We want the community to come up and help each other, because this is what is the larger purpose of this workshop, to generate a collaborative community. Now, first instruction, the start page, you are not supposed to edit this page. So over the past 2 weeks, the IIT Bombay team had daily monitored who changed the who made the changes. They were all reverted back to the main, the original settings. All you have to do is click on this particular contributing RC's page link that has been highlighted over here. So as a participant, once you log in, just find this contributing RC's page link, click on it. Then you will see a list of contributing. There is another page. This link is leads to another page which has a list of all the RCs who are participating in this workshop. Over here, you locate your RC. So the remote center number and the college remote center name will be given over here. You find out your RC, click on it. Once you click, so this is a sample example page of IIT Bombay RC. First, you have to, you will see a description. This description will be filled in by the remote center coordinator or the workshop coordinator. So in case your remote center page does not have this description, kindly ensure that the remote center coordinator or workshop coordinator is alerted and they provide information about the remote center. It will also have a list of participants from that remote center. Our IIT Bombay team has ensured that most of the participants who registered during the first week have also been put in this. You will find their names in blue, which corresponds to a link. You click on your name. So your name will be given by your RCID underscore your first name underscore your last name. So all you have to do is click on your name. This will lead you to your page. So you will see this edit window. In case your page has not been created yet, it will ask, should I create the page or cancel? So create the page over there. Then you will see an edit window. So that is this edit window. Every page will be open for 30 minutes for making edits. So within this time, you have to perform some operations and regularly check, click save. If you don't click save, this timer, when it becomes zero, whatever content you have typed till that time, it becomes saved. You will have to again go and edit it. So if you repeatedly save it, this timer will get reset to 30 minutes. So typically 30 minutes is the time window that you have for making edits and saving your page. So you will have to either click on save or cancel before the timer reaches zero. All participants are expected to populate this page. It will have some basic information about you, your the courses that you handle, the domain from which you teach, and any other things that you think are important for others to see. It will also have something called a teaching learning mission statement. It is about what you want as a teacher. So what is your mission as a teacher? And in the later weeks, you have to populate your flipped classroom activity. You have to provide links to your flipped classroom activity in this particular page. We'll tell you how it has been done. So this is for viewing the page. All you have to do is click on this view tab. You'll be able to view the page. So this is how others will be able to see the page. So if you can closely look, all the headings, there is something called edit. So at each heading level, you can edit it. So that is one feature of a Wiki. And what is expected in your course portfolio? Details about you, your domain, courses that you handle, your teaching learning mission statement. And we also want for weeks 2, 3, and 4, we want the flipped classroom design that you did as part of this workshop. So it should have the out of class design, which include the learning objective, links to the videos, either the selected ones or the created ones, and also the assessment strategies for the out of class activities, and the in class design, which will include learning objectives, the active learning strategy that you have designed. It could be a TPS, it could be something else that you have tried to implement. And finally, an assessment strategy. Basically, what this informs us is what you have learned through weeks 2, 3, and 4 of this FDP. We provide videos, we provided activities for design of flipped classroom. Now we need to see evidence of this learning transferring into your practice. So this is an intermediary. The lesson design is an intermediary for us to know that, yes, participants in this FDP have actually designed a flipped classroom for their own course. So each of you will have a flipped classroom design. So at the end of this weeks 2, 3, and 4, if we go RC wise, you can actually see all the flipped classroom designs from a particular RC. So this is what you loosely understand by creation of open education resource. And all these resources, you should put it under Creative Commons so that people from your domain, people from other RCs within your domain who are taking a same course as you will also get benefited from your design. One, they may be able to give you feedback. The other, they may actually use the same design that you have provided, if it is good, in their own course. And thus, it becomes, you become a collaborative community. Each one helping the other, either through feedbacks or through practice and then providing feedback. So one important thing is making sure that all these things come into a single repository, and this course portfolio wiki is the repository within Moodle we have given you for this purpose. And the next part is the peer review of the activities that you will be doing across weeks 2, 3 and 4 through various assignments in the Moodle. You'll actually be doing these peer reviews. So at the end of week 4, the week 4 deadline, we expect the course portfolio to have all these things. So I hope all of you understood the process.